So in the 1970s, developmental biology was really trying to answer the question, how do we go from a single cell organism to the complex human beings and creatures that we see populating the earth? Using animal models, they were able to determine the genes that controlled for body segmentation in fruit flies. When this gene was not working, the larva of the fruit fly appeared short, stubby, with spiny projections called denticles. These denticles gave the sea larva a hedgehog-like appearance, and thus the name hedgehog gene was assigned to those particular genes. After the discovery of the hedgehog gene in fruit flies, scientists then began to search for a similar gene in vertebrates. To their surprise, there's actually three homologous genes in vertebrates. To follow naming conventions, it was agreed upon that each new gene that was discovered would be named after a species of hedgehog. Naturally, initially there was the Indian hedgehog, the desert hedgehog, and the next in line was to be the common European hedgehog. However, Robert Riddle discovered a gene whose function far surpassed those of the ones previously found. Now, instead of naming it the common European hedgehog, he found inspiration in the most unlikely place. At the time, his 6-year-old daughter had just come back from England, and in her travels, she had picked up a comic book. This was a promotional comic for the soon-to-be character, Sonic the Hedgehog. He adopted the name and rejected the prescribed name of Common European Hedgehog and opted for the name Sonic Hedgehog instead. Whenever you defy convention, there's always going to be a pushback. However, he stuck with his guns, and Sonic Hedgehog was adopted as the name for the new gene. Shortly thereafter, Sonic the Hedgehog did come to the States, and a few naive scientists believed that the name had caught on so much that McDonald's had actually done a promotional Happy Meal behind the gene. So what is the function of the Sonic Hedgehog gene? Besides having a cool name, what does it do? Well, basically, this gene is responsible for your entire central nervous system. Everything from midline brain structures, to your limbs, to the thalamus, to your teeth, it introduces the floor plate of the notochord. Now, the notochord is basically the fledgling spinal cord in embryos. This notochord eventually becomes the gel-like substance that will fill up the spinal cord. Anyone who has ever slipped a disc, that pain we feel is the bulging of the notochord. In embryos, the notochord signals the production of the Sonic Hedgehog gene. This gene even controls the way the limbs are formed. In humans, we clearly have 2 legs, 2 arms. However, in whales and dolphins, this gene is responsible for the tail. As fun as the Sonic Hedgehog gene sounds, any malfunction in this gene has great consequences to an embryo.
Holoprosencephaly.
I think I said that right. Or HPE. Severe symptoms of HPE include malformations in the brain. There is no left or right lobe. Nose, eyes, and face can occur. Oftentimes, patients will lose their sense of smell. Anosmia, the nose will form above the eye. Cyclopsia, which is how it sounds, and you're literally born with 1 eye. I'm gonna show you pictures, but if you Google them, just be aware as well. On a lighter note, as is the case in genetics, genes can be turned on and off using inhibitors. Such an inhibitor has been found with the Sonic Hedgehog gene, and in true form, it was named Robotnik. Zebrafish have duplicate copies of 2 of them, the first being Tiggy Winkle Hedgehog, and the second being an Echidna Hedgehog. fans of Sonic the Hedgehog will know that a certain red character is an echidna. However, this gene is not named after him.